off of doing harm to a nigga. They get that's where they get their patches from. See, I'm gonna tell you about like Mexicans and white boys, when they put tattoos on them, they call patches. Niggas might get a Benjamin Franklin, some money, a bitch stripping or some shit. His neighborhood on his spot. Them crackers get cultural patches. You know what I'm saying? And they mean something to them. They can't get certain tattoos in that USP if they ain't put the work in for that tattoo. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You see them motherfucking Doc Martens with them red shoe strings and them cracking and killed the nigga. See what I'm saying? This what niggas don't know. You see that motherfucking chief holding that woman in his arm with them sandals on, my nigga. You know he's a hand. So you know what I'm saying? These are things that they script them. They script them out the gate. As soon as they come in, hey, take your clothes off. Serenias and Pisces couldn't walk pull out compound.
What you mean?
They couldn't walk that compound. They like that was a yard that they could not walk. 2011, they tried to force the Serenios and Pisces on Pollock Yard. Man, we stayed locked down like 6-7 months, like poking up behind them crackers trying to force Serenios and Pisces on the yard. But by rule, the Serenios and Pisces, if they get to the Pollock Yard, they gotta walk out there in sudden death. They literally gotta walk the fuck out there. You know what I'm saying? Like, knowing that bitch, it ain't no win. Man, I'm talking about.
Right, so who was on the yard before they got there?
It was Texas syndicates and Mexican mafia, Texas family. You know what I'm saying? Like they ran that like the Pisces, Serrano, and the Tango Blast until they got ran off the yard. You know what I'm saying?
So who ran the Tango Blast off the yard?
It was either the Mexican mafia or the Texas family. I can't remember. You know what I'm saying? I don't remember which one of them.
So they had three different Mexican gangs on the yard at one time?
Yeah. But they had a alliance, but they had like a, you know what I'm saying, like a hands-off policy. So they was letting them boys rock. But they ran them Tango Blast off, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Tango Blast.
And then they tried to bring the Serranos and the Pisces on the yard at the same time?
They tried to do that first in 2011.
That ain't gonna work.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? So, but they had just opened the FCI, so they sent all the Serranos and Pisces over to the Pollock FCI.
But they gonna crash over there anyway. They still gonna crash.
They check out what happened. They sent all the Serranos and Pisces to the FCI. So when motherfuckers going from the pen to FCIs, now they sending the Texas family and the Mexican mafia over to the FCI when they points drop. And then so you already know it's work. Man, they got into it with niggas. Man, they were throwing niggas in barbed wire. Man, I went over there to the FCI. I'm walking. These niggas don't even, you know, you get keen to certain shit when you in that penitentiary, just survival skills. You just real observing. We walk in the track. I'm like, damn, y'all niggas don't hear that shit. Man, these Mexicans in the bathroom sharpening knives all day, every day. And niggas just walk around oblivious to it. You know what I'm saying? It'd be an isolated incident where a Mexican might stab the shit out of a nigga or something like that. And then they know they getting off on niggas because this shit's supposed to went up. Man, they was over there dogging them niggas. And then niggas who done been in the pen, who ain't trying to go back, like, man, I ain't this shit here, renegade. This shit, anything goes. So this a race issue. So I had to get over all of that shit there too. I had to get over all of that shit there too. Matter of fact, bro, we had a homie, Eric Griffin, man. It's my nigga. Me and Eric went from Penn, went from Coleman together. We was at Pollock, Talladega, and we ended up here at my last spot was up here in Petersburg, Virginia. My nigga, when he in the vent. I see him coming in. You know, every time a bus coming in, I sit in that window because I've done a lot. You know what I'm saying?
So, yeah.
Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't just dropped everything. Like my survival skills, I done mask these motherfuckers. I'm walking with my hoodie on, but at the same time, bitch, I still see. So I sit in that window every time a bus coming in, my nigga, and watch them fuck moving and how they navigate. And, I seen him coming in, so I hit the wonder, ooh, this and that, Bob, we rap. He was above me getting the vent. tell me shit that changed. When, you know, once I meet my nigga, you know what I'm saying? I realized, like, and I told him, I said, bro, like, I'm like, bro, a lot of shit just ain't in me no more, my nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that ignorance and shit, I got some certifications. I'm a, you know, I'm a certified electrician, certified brick mason. I got my own clothing line, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? I teach the ACE courses over here on the stock market shit. Come with me. You know if I have motion. Of course I got motion. You know I got motion, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? But, at the same time, bro, I move a different kind of way, my nigga. I'm selective by who I deal with. Like, I'm not just trapping out my cell, homie. Like, I got about 4 or 5 motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying, that I can depend on that's going to spend it in this coming. But other than that, you know, and this all just for the to so when I touch down, because I know I'm finna go home, you know, but that's another spiel. So I see bro was still snapping. Bro still had that mentality. He had been down longer than me. At that time, he had been down like 24 years. Because I think he did like 26 altogether. But bro hadn't got his GED. Bro hadn't got, he hadn't did nothing but thug the whole bit.
Right.
Back from FCI back to the pen. FCI back to the pen. Busting niggas' heads open with locks. Coming back. You know what I'm saying? And you know, I don't watch the man. I don't watch. It's funny when you watch a nigga from the other side of the country. Age in prison, and as y'all meet back up, it's like, God damn, I done seen you done been to 4 spots. Like, and you, y'all done grew up together in this bitch, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, that's the hell of a.
We literally grew up, I don't know you from a past prison, I don't know you from a can of paint, but we literally done watched each other age, cap on a nigga face turn gray, nigga dreads fall, nigga bald head, not like. And it's real life, you know what I'm saying? Like, when them crackers park your ass like that, you gonna beat up. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, for sure.
If you ain't fighting, you know what I'm saying? If you think you gonna sit around, smoke, slumped over all day, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? You know, I see little buddy, he on TikTok, he having fun, all up in jail, got, he done ran up his followers and shit. Yeah, that's a facade, homie. Like, cause when that shit go off, and I watch him, I'm entertained by him, I show support, but I already know what that is, bro. Like, If he able to get out, you know what I'm saying? But man, boy, that shit, that misery, that shit lame. It's lame, homie. Anything that's doing time gonna tell you, boy, ain't no fuck all that talking about a nigga green, a nigga square, bro. Like, you know that, like, nigga, one thing, I'd rather be called a nigga than to be called an inmate. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
I'd rather fuck cracker to call me a nigga to my face than to call me an inmate. Cause if you call me a nigga, it's a chance I might be free. You call me an inmate, bitch, I'm liable to be liable. It's a 100% chance that I'm somewhere I ain't got no motherfucking business. Well, I'm an inmate. Man, yeah, like, you know what I'm saying?
Man, so, yeah. So what you seen, before you got out, what you seen a lot of young guys going inside, coming inside the prison for? What they been coming in with? Was it drug charge or the guns?
No, mainly for toting fire. And standing around doing nothing with that bitch. I ain't never shot the gun or nothing. You know what I'm saying? And the ones who did, bro, the ones who was out there using it, wish they never would have done it. They wish they never would have done it. For whatever reason they did it for. They might have slid on some nigga, because you calling the nigga your op. You know what I'm saying? You know, nigga jump off the, like, when we jumped off the porch, because we wanted some money. It was out of necessity. Like, bitch, I need some new shoes. You know, I want to fix up a broom. Bitch, I want to go drop me a wall in my shit. You know what I'm saying? I want a chunk.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I need some money to give me some, I need some pussy, or I just need a roof over my head, whatever the case may be.
Right.
These niggas jumping off the porch, and that's all they wanted, some ops. Man, I got niggas right now, homie. I'm telling my young niggas that I love these little niggas. And the crazy part, a lot of these niggas be sharp and intelligent, but they allow themselves to be manipulated by what's perceived to be culture now. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't have no individuality. You can hear it in the rap. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
There's no individuality. Like, you listen to it, everybody want to sound like Young Thug, Lil Baby, or Kodak Black. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, you know, when we grew up, everybody wanted their own style. You know, don't sweat my technique, nigga. I got my own, my style. You had 9 niggas in the Wu-Tang Clan, and every last one of them rapped a different kind of
had a different style. You're right. Everybody had their own different style. Back then, you didn't want to sound like somebody else. You wanted to sound like yourself.
You had Madball, Ooze, and Poison Clan. Like, none of them niggas rap like Jay-Z Money. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
Everybody had their own version of their style. Like, And it's like, now it's like, oh, everybody done morphed into one. And it's crazy because when you don't have that level of individuality, what you have is a bunch of blind men leading blind men. You know, it's a blind male. I'm not even gonna call a nigga no man. Niggas got male parts. You know what I'm saying? Because male comes with the physical. Man comes with the mentality. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, if you ain't got that mentality, my nigga, it just ain't in you. Like, you ain't gonna be doing. I just told a nigga, I was just in the county jail, and me and a nigga, like, we couldn't see eye to eye for shit. Because we was older. We was in our 40s. And it was a bunch of young niggas in there. These young niggas, 19, 21 years old, 23 years old, facing death penalty, homie. Right there in Pinellas County. Facing death penalties, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, life sentences.
Right.
And the nigga in there telling these little niggas not to go to court, and these niggas fucking quit like that. I'm like, bro, that day coming. You know, I Scarface say overlooking it tomorrow, then it finally came. Like, nigga, oh no, you crackers gonna come drag you to that courtroom. You going to court. Like, I'm like, bro, why did you keep giving these little niggas the fucked up version of the game, homie? Like,
yeah, giving the homie a bad game.
Exactly. I'm saying, bro. I'm saying, bro, we in our 40s. You being in your 40s, still doing what you was doing at 25, talking about, nigga, I ain't never gonna change. These niggas switching up with this shit. I'm like, nah, this jail shit lame. You over there yelling on that phone to a bitch on the other end, my nigga, for what she doing with what's hers, my nigga. Like that's lame. Like, nigga, you can't control nothing. Everybody know you can't control no bitch from jail. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
for sure.
It was. And I'm saying, you in your 40s. Calling home, cussing motherfuckers out as if that's gonna make the motherfucker ride with you. You ain't got no finesse. I'm like, bro, like, how the fuck you in your 40s still so-called doing what it make me feel? You must have wasn't doing it. And now you feel like you got a little more temperament because these young niggas calling you OG because they, to them, you is. But the truth is, like, you not really no OG because, bitch, you ain't showed no growth. Because if you doing in your 40s, what you was doing in your teens and early 20s, my nigga, something is seriously wrong, homie. Like, what these niggas is calling gangster is more or less...
Crashing out, really.
It's emotional immaturity, my nigga, you know what I'm saying? Undiagnosed psychiatric trauma. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't been diagnosed as a psych patient, but you truly a psych patient. Like, everything need an emotional reaction from you. Yeah, men don't perpetrate them roles, homie. Like, you ain't got no finesse with you. You don't have no strategy to you. Everything is, it's easy to play you out of pocket.
Hey, I got a question for you. Have you been keeping up with that Young Dolph trial?
No, to be honest, because I done seen that movie before.
Right.
I've seen that movie before. I already know what's gonna happen. I see little snippets or whatever on TV.
They didn't understand when they were sitting back conspiring to knock off Thug, right? They were really conspiring to take their own self out at the same time, homie.
Oh, ain't no question. It was kill two birds with no stones. It's the same shit. Them guys been playing, and it's crazy because, you know what I'm saying, not even get too spiritual, my nigga, but like, my nigga, if you got in and out of the literal sense of the Bible, where the Pharaoh said, let us go down and deal with the children of Israel wisely. See, them crackers ain't wisely. They dealing with us
wisely.
It take 24 years for the human brain to fully develop, to understand the long-term effects and consequences of its behavior. That's a scientifically proven fact based on psychology. So, okay, so majority of us, by the time we turn 24, 25, well, them crackers done already, we done been to juvenile program, a couple state prison bit. Oh, now we got enough charge to go ahead and charge this nigga as a career criminal, my nigga, and go get him out the way for at least 20, 25 years. You see what just happened, my nigga? By the time you turn 25 years, they got rid of parking big, my nigga, early. The nigga with kids when they die, homie.
Yeah.
26 years old.
For sure. Yeah, for sure. They were jits.
See what I'm saying? But the level of, it's like, if you understand that level of dynamic and like how these niggas ended up getting the whole country in their clutch, my nigga, and if they understand what to do with. But don't get me wrong, I get these little niggas that one that do have, who in these positions, they getting wise or not. These little niggas are seeing what's happening to Thug. They seeing what happened to Dolph. They seeing what's, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas like, oh, hell no, bruh. I'm watching Kodak. He getting old and he's peeping. He's like, oh, no, he got a plan. They banking on me to be high, suited out my mind, so they can keep playing with me, my nigga, with the numbers and the paperwork and shit. No, I need to be a little more sober. You know what I'm saying? To see where I'm going. Like, niggas is actually finding direction, but it's in that old school way is dying out. Now, you got to understand, the children of Israel had to stay in the wilderness for 40 years for them old niggas to die out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that they can flourish, my nigga, without filth. Because, you know, this is their system. The crackers, you know, slavery was based on filth. You know what I'm saying? Like, religion and all of that shit, though, based on filth. Prison, keep your ass in check, is based on filth. But once niggas get the paper game, oh, we out of here. Because now I realize, like, okay, niggas realizing, okay, damn, that's selling all that motherfucking dope, that crack and shit, oh, that ain't the way to go. We finna play with some of this fraud now. You know what I'm saying? Okay, the fraud, you know, when I first came in, the fraud, even the meth, I see a crack, you cover four bricks of meth, you ain't even know how to charge it. GHB, all that shit, Puffy getting fucked up over right now.
That's like a pimping status, right?